गुड मॉर्निंग। हाउ मच टाइम डू यू स्पेंड ऑन जॉब पोर्टल? इट्स 10 मिनट पर डे और मे बी 1 आवर 2 आवर पर डे। एंड आफ्टर स्पेंडिंग दैट मच टाइम डू यू रियली गेट द रिजल्ट विच इज रिक्वायर्ड? डू यू फील दैट यू आर एट द पोजिशन वेयर यू डिजर्व टू बी? इफ द आंसर इज नो और इफ द आंसर इज यस, choice yourself. Stay tuned till the end of the video. We are going to discuss 10 point that is overrated, which you should not do in your job search journey. 10 point to avoid, or these points are overrated, which we should not follow during our job search journey. Let's quickly jump into all those 10 point. Number one, I often heard from so many people that your resume should be very perfect. You should spend too much time on your resume. You should customize your resume according to the job description, and you should spend maximum time on your resume. I agree, but I don't agree. Now, let me tell you the science behind this. Your resume should be perfect. Spend at least 10 minutes or maximum 1 hour per month on your resume. Create a master template, and after creating that master template, open your antenna, open your radar. Your radar should always be open whenever you get any job interview call. Get the job description, customize your resume within 5 minutes, not more than that. And after that you should spend time building relationship and making connection on professional networks such as LinkedIn and Glassdoor and Indeed. Maybe in Indeed you cannot build connection, but at least you can follow the recruiter whom you resonate. So number one, don't waste too much time on your resume. Rather than, you should invest your time building connection and building relationship over a professional network such as LinkedIn. Very much important. Number two, I heard many people used to say, just give any interview. Even I did this mistake in 2008 and 2009. I used to go anywhere and everywhere for the interview. Even I went for the interview with a company is not even genuine. The company is self fake. They are asking money for even interview. But I went there. I just wanted to see the experience. I wanted to experience why these companies are called fake companies and why these companies are even called not genuine. I went, but don't do this mistake. I did this mistake. I am requesting you, don't do this mistake. Don't go anywhere and everywhere for the interview. Rather going anywhere and everywhere for the interview, you should do proper research. Do proper planning. Check, note down your industry, note down your organization, your dream companies where you want to get shortlisted or you want to get even work. Do proper planning, do proper research before appearing into the interview rather than going anywhere and everywhere for the interview. Point number two. Yes. And point number three. Do you really think your education matter? Do you really think if you mention all your education, it will add any value in the organization? Let's suppose there is a person and his percentage is 90% in all the education throughout all the 9 CGPA, and he got shortlisted with one of the organization and he is not able to work. He don't even have idea what to do, what not to do. Do you really think that person will add any value in the organization? So rather than focusing on education or percentage, you should focus on experience and practical hands-on. Now the question is, you may ask with me, if I am not even getting job, how will I get the experience? It is up to you, my dear friend. My own brother, my real brother, he is in engineering. He is in final year and Right now, he is getting very good experience without even getting the job. How? Create your profile on freelancer.com. Go ahead, bid your project, bid your experience, bid your knowledge, and get the project. Get it hands-on. Do it, deliver. Simple. At least you should know the practical knowledge. And if you're not even capable or confident about this, go ahead, join any training organization. They will give you practical hands-on. So rather than focusing on education, focus on practical hands-on. Focus on doing live project. Number one, resume. Number two, don't go anywhere and everywhere. Do proper research. Number three, get practical hands-on. Get practical knowledge. It will add the value to yourself as well as to the organization. And it will win-win-win situation. Now, number four, I often used to heard people used to say, I want to get the job in bigger companies only. I need job in Fortune 500. I need job in Fang. Do you really think let's suppose you got job in Facebook or you got job in Google, do you have the access to the decision maker? Do you really have the access to the decision maker if you want to do anything, if you want to implement anything new, and if you want to even give your idea to the higher management, do you have the access in those big organizations, those so-called big daddies in this job industry? The answer is no. So rather than focusing on big industries, Fortune 500, this, that, maybe you can start your job, start your experience with a small organization. No, I'll tell you, it is not easy to be a small fish in a big pond. But there are so many startups and a small organization. They have started playing very vital role in job industry nowadays. Job industry is growing, my dear friend. There must be people used to say that industry is down due to COVID. It was. Now there is no thing like that. You should focus on growing rather than complaining this is down, this is that. Check which is growing. Go ahead, participate, get the job, get the money, get experience. So next one is, rather than focusing on big daddies in the organization, bigger companies, focus on a small organization where you can be reach out to the decision maker very easily. You can share your ideas to the decision maker or higher management very easily. And by this way, you will be standing out from the crowd. You are already one step ahead. If you have the idea and you are sharing to the higher management, and by luck it has been implemented, you are the creator. Right? And next one. I often used to heard people used to say, stick to one field. If you started your journey with, let's suppose, developer, be the developer. Let me tell you about myself. I started my job search journey. I started my job journey with call center. I worked with call center at least for 1 year. And that too, also I worked in night shift. Then I went into development. And then I went into support. Then I went to IT support. And then I went into management and lead role. And so focus on your skill. Be open to learn anything which you can grow. Be open to learn anything which can help you to grow. Rather than sticking to one field. I have seen people used to say, I am into automation or I'm into testing since 2 years. My next follow-up question used to be, okay, so what did you learn? I didn't learn anything. I just used to fill the Excel sheet. So my dear friend, why you are wasting your time if you are not enjoying the time there? Learn something which is productive, where you can grow, and go ahead. Now the next one, number 6. I often used to heard from the people, if your resume is perfect, you don't have to be a brand. You don't have to be a social presence on social media. Online presence. You don't have to have an online presence. Now, industry is changing. Job market has been changed rapidly. You have to have a personal brand. You have to have your social presence or online presence. And if you don't have, you will face very much difficult in your job search journey, because nowadays recruiter used to check the background verification by social presence only. So check if you have the social presence, good, and if you don't have, go ahead, create a profile on LinkedIn, create a profile on Google, and there is one more website called siliconindia.com. It's very much profitable website to make yourself as a brand. As soon as people will search you on Google, you will be the first person to come in the first page, siliconindia.com. And next one, I often used to heard from the people, focus on salary. Now my question is, if you 100% focus on salary and the organization culture, their job environment is very toxic, people used to talk negative and they are unprofessional, so leave about this behavior and all. Let me ask you one question. I'll give you 20 lakh per month, 20 lakh per month, but you have to work 23 hours a day and it's a calling job. Will you be able to do? Will you accept that offer 23 hours a day and you have to be on the call? Is it okay? For me, it is not. Even when I was working with Infosys, they have given me a laptop and they used to call me night 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. So I don't focus most on salary. I focus on work environment, culture, their professional behavior, and their online presence. Best place to work. Go ahead and check in Google. Best place to work. Which industry is best place to work? And try to get the job there, rather than focusing on big organization. Now the next one. I have often used to heard from the people, you don't need reference. Professional reference is not required. See, if you are very confident about your skill, if you are very much confident about your knowledge, expertise, then also at least one reference will be required. Maybe not now, after some year of experience. So build good relationship with everyone. You never know which reference can help you at which place. Build relationship, create reference. And if you are not able to create reference, be the reference. Now the next one, there is one person who called me all, I think almost 6-7 months back, and he used to struggle with the job. Now he's a part of my community, and he said, I used to apply anywhere and everywhere, but I'm still waiting for the interview call. My next question was, okay, which area you are expert, what is your expertise? And the answer was blank. So rather than applying anywhere and everywhere, check yourself what is your area of expertise and focus on that rather than applying anywhere and everywhere. And the last but not the least, I have seen people used to lie in their resume. They will see, my friend is doing well, let's suppose he is doing well in any role, I'll copy paste in my resume, prepare some cross question, and I'll present myself into the interview. So this was the thinking for some of the people. Don't do this mistake. Don't lie in your resume. If you lie in your resume, see, my question is, if you lie to yourself, do you really think you can grow? Don't do this mistake, my dear friend. So that's all for today. 10 important topic, 10 important point to be discussed, which we have discussed just now. And if you feel that you deserve a very good ATS proof, 100% ATS proof, amazing resume, go ahead, click the link below and grab your ATS proof resume template free of cost. And 31st of July, morning 11:30, Saturday, we are conducting free mock interview session in association of Sahyog Charitable Foundation. So if you want to brush your knowledge in the field of HR interview, go ahead, click the link below, grab your chair, and I'll see you on sharp morning 11:30, 31st of July. Take care, keep learning, keep shining, all the best.